Anydesk is the fastest and most affordable remote control software in the world. You can access your devices on all platforms. Let's see how to install Anydesk on Android. First, we need to go to Google Play. So, open Google Play. On the search above, write Anydesk. Now tap on the search. After you have found the app, just tap on Install and wait. You have now installed Anydesk on your Android device. After the install is complete, just tap on Open. When you open the app, you will get a tutorial on what you can do on the app. You will see here the ID of your phone. Also, you will have the possibility to connect to a remote address here. Now, let's check a bit the settings. Tap on the menu from the left. Here, tap on Settings. Let's tap on General. On this page, you will be able to set up an alias for your phone. This way, you will not need to send the ID of your phone, but a phrase that you can remember. This is good for you and for the person who gets the info. After you write a unique phrase, tap Register. Now let's go back by tapping the arrow from the top. Now let's tap on Security. Here, you will be able to set up what access you wish to give to the person who knows the ID or the alias. If you put on Interactive Access, Allow Always, then even if the app is not open, person can get to your phone. If you tap on Allow Only If Any Desk Window Is Open, then for somebody to connect to your phone, you need to have the app opened. Also, you can set up some password for unattended access to your phone. This means that the person who has the password can enter without any confirmation. You have other options that you can check here. Now let's go back by tapping the arrow from the top. Now let's tap on Privacy. Here we can set up a username for your device. Tap on the current username to edit. Also, you can add an image to this username. And set if you wish to show the wallpaper on an Anydesk connection. Now let's go back by tapping the arrow from the top. Let's tap on Input. Here we find the option Enable Automatic Keyboard. This feature will enable if the keyboard appears when the text input field is tapped. Also, we have the touch mode, if we wish to use a direct mouse mode or a touchpad mode. Now let's tap on Display. On Display, we have an option about the quality of the transmitted connection. We can set up to have the best quality or the best speed or an optimized connection. I will choose that. Also, we have the option to see the remote cursor on the device we connect to. Now let's tap on Audio. Here we have two important features. If we wish so that the person who connect to hear what we hear on the microphone on the device, we can enable this. If we have checked this, we will need to allow permission to Anydesk to record audio. Also, if we want the person to hear what we hear when we play a video, then we need to enable playback. This is useful if we show that person a video and we wish to hear the sound also. On the VPN and connection part, we will skip. Because how you can see, there are a lot of complicated settings that most of you will not use. The last part we will talk is recordings. Here, we can set up that every time a session starts to automatically record it. Also, we can record incoming sessions and outgoing sessions, depending on what we want. So, these are the settings from Anydesk. We have now the software installed on our device. If this was useful, please like, share and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them on the comments area below.